everybody. Welcome back. It's Monday. You know what time it is. It's tea time. This week, I'm talking about the Circle Jerks. I got into these guys back when I was in, I think, about 10th grade, skateboarding at my buddy Levi's house on his half pipe. They were constantly playing the album Six, and that is when I fell in love with this band. They've released many albums over the years. I've got a few t-shirts over the years. The first one that I ever had, I don't have anymore. A friend of mine gave it to me in high school, and I literally wore that thing every day. It was just a picture of their skanking logo guy dancing in front of a crowd at the bottom of a stage. It was just barely held together for a thread, and I wore it all the time. But the first one that I have, I actually picked this up, I believe at Gabe's, believe it or not. I got this one for like $5. I walked in and I saw it and I lost my crap. I love this. It's the old skanking guy. And I didn't realize how many other shirts that I have that actually parody this. I have an old Op Ivy t-shirt that after 20 some years, I put them back to back and realized it's the same skanking guy. It's just, he's clothed differently. Circle Jerks played a few times down at the Underground Railroad in the Dry House back in the 80s here in town. Of course, I never got to see them, but I did finally get to see them in 2022 for the very first time, and it was an incredible show. So these next couple of shirts I have come from that show. This one again, of course, is the skanking guy, but from more of my comfort on a black t-shirt. Same design as the white one, but this one's awesome because they were touring with 7 Seconds and Negative Approach. And so on the back, this one's got all the tour dates from that show. Unfortunately, 7 Seconds, those guys had COVID, and so they missed the Pittsburgh date of the show that we went to. But I've seen them a few times. Also, the great added bonus that Negative Approach was on this show, and those guys put on an awesome show. They were a lot of fun. Circle Jerks were incredible. They played everything I wanted to hear. I also got this one at the show. This one's cool. It's like an old school flyer. And of course, it's got Circle Jerks, 7 Seconds, all three of their logos on here. This is definitely one of my favorite ones. I think Trust Records put this one out. The sales from this shirt, they actually split evenly between all the bands to give them gas money. And I believe they also had it on their website to help take care of the guys when they all had COVID and missed a few legs of this tour. If you got to see that show, it was awesome. But over the years, Circle Jerks have held a near and dear place in my heart. They've got a bunch of albums. Photos will come up so you can check them out. If you know them, you know them. If you've never heard them, you can find them. They're on the internet. I'll try to put some links in the description so you can check them out. Of course, the guys in Circle Jerks have been in other bands as well, including Bad Religion. Keith also has another band, Off. They've got a few records out. Really good stuff, still in the same kind of vein as Circle Jerks. Fast, aggressive, California old school hardcore punk. Really, really good stuff. Thanks for tuning in, guys. I'll be back next week with another one. Take it easy.